Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspen Tech channel, and our today's lecture, which is lecture number 102, is linked with our previous lecture, which was lecture number 101, in which we had discussed and simulated production of N-octane from ethylene and isobutane. And carrying forward in lecture number 102, we will be doing the process-to-process heat recovery, and in other terms, we can say the efficiency enhancement of this production process. But what was that process which we have simulated in lecture number 101? We will first see that one, and I will show you the process from lecture number 101, its flow sheeting, process requirements, and the final simulated flow sheet. So this is the overall schematic diagram of the production of N-octane, and this process starts from this point number one, which is the feed, and initially we will obviously give the feed without recycle system into this reactor, and this reactor is provided the external heat as well. This reactor is an isothermal reactor. It means feed temperature and the product temperature will remain the same. Conversion reactor will take place in this reactor. Then the separation process takes place, and in this column the stream number 4 and stream number 5 are produced. The stream number 4 is further split into two parts, 6 and 7. This is a purge stream, and this stream is recycled. And how it is recycled? First, it is compressed, then it is cooled down to the temperature as that of the feed temperature, and then is recycled. And this mixer provides a junction or a part for the recycling process, that this feed is mixed with the recycled one, and then the total stream is entering this reactor. And the number 3 and number 5 are our product streams, which contain high purity and octane, and we will see it once we will be doing the simulation process. So the components and property package which are involved in this simulation exercise are ethylene and butane, isobutane and octane and nitrogen, and the property package which we will be using is Peng-Robinson. The feed specifications: the temperature of the feed is 93 degrees centigrade, the pressure is 20 psia, and the molar flow rates of each component is given, that ethylene is 20 kg mol per hour, 0.5 for n-butane, 10 for i-butane, and 0.1 for nitrogen. For the reaction, 2 moles of ethylene reacts with 1 mole of isobutane to form 1 mole of normal octane, and we are assuming 98% conversion of ethylene in this process because we are using a conversion reactor. Pressure drop of 7 psi in the reactor, and this is an isothermal reactor, as I have already told you in the description. In the distillation column, top product phase is vapor, light key in bottoms ethylene 0.0015, heavy key in distillate and octane 0.28. Pressure of condenser is 15 psia, pressure of reboiler is 25 psia. Accordingly, based on these parameters, we will get a value of minimum reflux ratio, and we will compute, or we will specify, external reflux ratio over there. Then in T, split ratio of purge and product or the recycle one, purge is 0.1 while the product or recycle one is 0.9. obviously we want maximum quantity to be recycled and minimum quantity to be purged. And the compressor outlet pressure is 22 psia. For the cooler, the pressure drop is 0 psia and the outlet temperature is 93 degrees centigrade, which is same as that of the feed specification. So this one is the final flow sheet, which has been developed as a result of all of the parameters and the connection of all of the equipments. Now you can see that this feed is at 93 degrees centigrade. However, usually the feeds are not available at such high temperature, so this factor was ignored in the previous video. So what we need to do, we need to first disconnect this stream from the system, like deleting it from this mixer. Obviously the process will not solve, but take it out from here and connecting it to the system. And then what we need to do, we need to install a heater over here, which will actually lead it to the required conditions. So what we need to do, this one is the feed, which is at inlet. We can label it as stream number 12, then Q5 is the energy of it. There is a delta P obviously, but you can see this feed is the same as that of the required to be inlet in the system. So what we need to do, we need to first change the conditions over here, and currently the conditions are 30 degrees centigrade, 24 psia. The rest of the conditions of composition and mass flow rate will remain the same. And here it is 20 psia and 93 degrees centigrade. So you can see it is now solved. So basically, if I explain it now for further understanding, that this feed was actually the given in the system. Now what we have done, we have changed the conditions of the feed to that of the actual feed before heating process, and this 12 is now our the feed which will go to this process. So what we need to do, this 12 is now entered in the system, and you can see all of this is converged, and again the answers will remain the same. There will be no change in the answer because this feed, which is now 12 and before doing this process, is same. Like this 12 is equal to that of the previous feed before installing this setup. Now you can see the total amount of energy required to heat or to preheat the feed from 30 degrees centigrade to 93 degrees centigrade with a pressure drop of 4 psia is 36.58 kilowatt. And here you can see this Q4, this is a cooler and this is a heater. So this one, this Q4 is 3.015. So here we have to provide a cold utility, here we have to provide a hot utility. However, if we integrate these two, what we can do, we can minimize this heat and we can quickly remove this cold utility. Like this 8 is at 98.92 degrees centigrade and it needs to be cooled down to 93 degrees centigrade. Here it needs to be heated from 30 to 93 degrees centigrade. But if we couple these two, E100 and E101, then what we can do, we can completely eliminate this 3.015 kilowatt from the system, which is the external utility. And accordingly, if you subtract it from here, then roughly 33.6 kilowatt of energy will be required and remaining will be removed. So what we need to do, we need to delete these heaters from the system. Like we will quickly do this, but we will first delete it only because only cold utility requirement will be met. But obviously we will still be needing this heater in the system and we will installing it. Tube side inlet is 8, tube side outlet is 9. So this one is 8 and 9 are connected to this block. Obviously we can realign it as per our requirement. And this feed is now firstly disconnected from this block because it will be first going to this heat exchanger one. And let me take it here and simply rotate it to adjust it. And shell side inlet is feed, and we can label it as like 13 stream because we have defined till the 12. And in worksheet, now you can see the number 8 temperature is unknown because it is coming from the previous part. Number 9 temperature we want is 93 degrees centigrade. The feed temperature is 30 degrees centigrade and this one is still remain the unknown. Now in design, in parameters, we will specify a pressure drop of 2 psia on both shell and tube side. Now after specifying these, and let me realign it quickly, that this heat exchanger feed is entering here, number 13 is coming out, it is the hot stream which is cooled down, feed is the cold stream which is heated in the process. Now this 13 needs to be connected with this one for the completion of the task. And now you can see all of this is converged. You can see because of the one unknown of 8, all of this was not converging. So once we connected this 13 with this one, the compositions were known, we knew the outlet temperatures, the outlet temperature was calculated actually, and you can see this all has been converged. So if I summarize it, that we have connected to this heat exchanger and we have specified the pressure drops only. There was no need to specify this number 13's temperature because it would have been calculated from the system. The number of temperature was known, but at that point it was not given or not calculated by HiSys because of incomplete condition. But once you have connected this 13 to this point, it has turned on the iterations and accordingly calculated the temperature of 8, calculated the temperature of 13, and accordingly the whole system was calculated in the process. So that's the overall representation of process to process heat recovery in the process. And you can see that by a result of this, instead of using a cooler block, a heat exchanger is installed, the cooling utility is minimized and completely eliminated from the system. The hot utility is still there, but now it is 34.97 kilowatt in the system, which was earlier 36.58 kilowatt in the system. So that's how you take the measures and necessary steps to reduce utilities in the system. And this is process integration example where we have reduced the utilities, which are the external for which you need to pay extra money. You have installed exchanger for process to process heat recovery and thus enhancing the efficiency of the system. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos.